We want to find the slope of the line passing through the given points, then determine if the line would be increasing, decreasing, horizontal, or vertical. To find the slope of a line given two points on the line, we want to find the change of y and divide by the change of x, which means we'll find the difference of the y coordinates and divide by the difference of the x coordinates. Then once we find the slope, if it's positive, negative, zero, or undefined, it'll determine whether the line is increasing, decreasing, horizontal, or vertical. If the slope is positive, the line is increasing as we see here. Notice as x increases, y also increases. We can also read this from left to right. From left to right, the line is going up, the slope is positive. If the slope is negative or less than zero, the line is decreasing, which means as x increases, y decreases, or as we move from left to right along the line goes downhill. If the slope is zero, then we have a horizontal line. Notice for any horizontal line, the change of y would be zero for any change of x. Zero divided by a constant will always be zero. Notice as x increases, the y value remains constant. And then finally, if the slope is undefined, we have a vertical line. The reason the slope is undefined is because notice how for a vertical line, the change of x would be zero, therefore we'd have division by zero, which is undefined. So going back to our two examples, let's go ahead and find the slope. Let's label our coordinates to keep organized. We'll call this x sub 1, comma y sub 1, and this point will be x sub 2, comma y sub 2. And therefore the slope is going to be equal to, again, y sub 2 minus y sub 1 divided by x sub 2 minus x sub 1. So we'd have 2/3 minus 3/4 divided by negative 3/4 minus 1/2. To perform the subtraction here, we'll have to obtain a common denominator. When our denominators are 3 and 4, the least common denominator would be 12, so we'll multiply 2/3 by 4 over 4 to convert to 12s. We'll multiply 3/4 by 3 over 3 to convert to 12s. Then looking at the change of x, we have a denominator of 4 and 2. The least common denominator would be 4, so multiply 1/2 by 2 over 2 to convert to 4ths. So now we have the slope. It's going to be equal to, we have 8/12 minus 9/12 divided by negative 3/4 minus 2/4. So this would give us, what, negative 1/12 divided by, this would be negative 5/4. Now remember, a fraction bar means division. So this means negative 1/12 divided by negative 5/4. So instead of dividing though, we can multiply by the reciprocal of negative 5/4. This is equivalent to negative 1/12 times negative 4/5. Notice how we have a common factor of 4 here. There's 1, 4, and 4, and 3, 4s, and 12. So we have a negative times a negative, and therefore the slope is equal to positive 1/15. And because the slope is positive, we can say the line would be increasing. Now let's find the slope of the second line passing through these two points. Again, we'll call these the ones and these the twos. So we'll have the slope. It's going to be equal to, again, y sub 2 minus y sub 1 divided by x sub 2 minus x sub 1. So we'll have negative 3/4 minus 5/6 divided by 2/3 minus negative 2/5. When the denominators are 4 and 6, the least common denominator would be 12. To convert negative 3/4 to 12, so you multiply by 3 over 3. To convert 5/6 to 12, so you multiply by 2 over 2. Looking at the change of x, if our denominators are 3 and 5, the least common denominator would be 15. Multiply 2/3 by 5 over 5. And negative 2/5 by 3 over 3. So here we have negative 9/12 minus 10/12 divided by, this would be 10 fifteenths. Here we have minus a negative, that'll become plus a positive, so plus 6 fifteenths. So we have negative 19 twelfths divided by 16 fifteenths. Again, let's write this as a multiplication problem. This is equivalent to negative 19 twelfths times the reciprocal of 16 fifteenths, which would be 15 sixteenths. Notice 12 and 15 share a common factor of 3. 4 threes in 12 and 5 threes in 15. So the slope of our line is going to be equal to negative 19 times 5, that's negative 95, over 4 times 16, that's 64. This does not simplify, but because the slope is negative, the line would be decreasing. Before we go, let's go ahead and plot these points on the coordinate plane to make sure this first line would be increasing or going uphill from left to right, and the second line would be decreasing or going downhill from left to right. Here's our first example. Notice as x increases, the y values also increase, so this line is increasing. It's going uphill from left to right. And our second example, passing through these two points, as x increases, notice the y values decrease, so this line is decreasing or going downhill from left to right. I hope you found this helpful.